Baku Mobile World Cup, this time a replay between Flame Victory and FLCL. I did miss this live because there were three games going on at the same time. I have two computers. I try to record as many games live as possible as I can, but yeah, sometimes it's just not possible. So I have to do the replay. This type of team is used in World Cup. It's spammed. I've seen it like 12 times. It's usually Rox, Wish, Clef into you have Wish Path into Zemo, Heatran, Spikes, Ferrothorn, Megalady, Scarf, Landris. Greninja is usually Battleborn, but it can also be Protean. And Ferrothorn can be changed. Like I've seen this these 5 months like so often, and then sometimes Tangrowth or Bulu over Ferrothorn. And yeah, on FLCL side, only potential Scarfers are the Heatran and the Greninja. I would assume probably the Greninja, and then most likely the same as on Effie side, probably Rock Swish Clef into Zemo Heatran. Gastrodon to check Heatran and Greninja, and also can switch into Megalady Psychic. And then the Tornadus, most likely Rocky Helmet, because he's kind of weak to Kartana, and then Mega Morwile. So if he's Scarf Grand, that's a good lead for FLCL, because he can just U-turn out if he doesn't like his matchup. So he does just lead with that. I have it on fast, let me put it on normal. So if he leads with Clef, he's most likely just going to get up the rocks. Even if the Greninja has a Gung Shot, it doesn't Oko the Clef. So I assume we see U-turn into either Morwile or Heatran here from FLCL, and most likely the rocks go up from Flame Victini. So Heatran comes out. Probably Megalady is going to come out here. So if FLCL has Toxic or Wisp, he can go to the, for that, expecting the Lady to come out. Or he can also just throw up the rocks if he has them. But like I said, I assume the rocks are most likely on the Clefable, so I assume he's going to either Magma or Wisp slash Toxic to try and hit the Lady. So he does go for Will-O-Wisp, that's a good play. And that means Heatran can take Earthquake from Lady better. But we're going to see a switch here most likely into Gastrodon or Clefable. Greninja is also a potential switch because Megalady usually doesn't carry Drago. Usually it carries Psychic, Ice Beam, Earthquake and Recover. But yeah, obviously you're not going to stay in here even though this is burned. You still don't want to take an Earthquake. So switch into this or this could come out. Does Effie have a double that covers Gastrodon and Clefable? I guess he could double into Heatran predicting the Clef. Well, let's see what he does. I assume he might just go for Earthquake. He does double into Heatran, breathe in the Clef. And now, obviously, FLCL doesn't want to stay in here. He doesn't have a good switch in. He has to either go Greninja or Gastrodon. And if this has, like, Toxic, it can hit the Gastrodon. So, yeah, if he has Toxic, he can definitely click it and hit the Gren or the Gastrodon switch. So, he does just go for Magma Storm. Now, Gastrodon is trapped in. And he's either going to Earthquake or Recover here. And Effie is either going to switch out, or if he has Bloom Dome, he can go for that and pop the Gastrodon. So he does go for Zemoth, and it's Bloom Dome, and Gastrodon just dies. So yeah, you can see the core on Flame Victini's side. He has Magma Bloom Dome, which means you're trapped in stuff like Gastrodon. They cannot switch out, they're trapped in from Magma Storm, and then your Protein Greninja or Battleborn Greninja gets opened up. So Greninja just became a huge threat. And now, FLCL goes to his own Tran. Maybe he doesn't have a move. Nah. Well, I guess if he goes Greninja, that would just allow Effie to go Ferrothorn, and he would have to U-turn predict. And if Effie stays in on U-turn, that puts him in an even worse spot than he already is. And he's already in a tough spot now without Gastrodon. Gastrodon was his main way of walling Lady and Greninja, because Lady can easily break through Clefable, because like Fizdev Clef has to recover spam. Like the Fables, they all run Bolt these days, especially on a team like this where you don't have another Zygarde answer. It has to be Bolt Clef. So Lady just spams Psychic and gets to Fish Force with Death Drop, and Clef is not a great answer for that. But yeah, he goes his own Tran, and well, I assume Effie doesn't want to risk the Speeder here, or maybe FLCL's Tran has Bolt to live off power. So I assume we're gonna see the Lady come out here from Effie, and maybe FLCL. Oh, he goes Gren, okay. FLCL pulls a double into Clef, anticipating the Lady. Or if this is Ash Grin, the Clefable also covers the Greninja. Now, I assume we're going to see the rocks go up from FLCL. And Flame Victini depends on his Greninja set. If he's Protean, he can probably gunk the Clef. If he doesn't have a move to hit the Clef, he's probably just going to switch back to his Heatran. Or to his Ferrothorn to get up a spike. But I assume FLCL is just gonna get the rocks up. Effie does have Gung Shot. Okay, so yeah, we can you can see the guy the core on Effie's team. This Greninja has Gang that hits Clefable for Megalody, so he doesn't even have to hope for Spadef drops, and Bloom Doom Trend traps stuff like Gastrion, so yeah, like cool offensive core there. And now he can just click like Pump Ice Beam or whatever he has. He doesn't have to risk hitting another Gang shot, so yeah, that's gonna be able to pick up the Clef. And now FLCL is forced into probably his Greninja, because if he goes Marble and this has HP Fire, that could be really bad. And oh, he goes Taunt. Well, does Taunt have an Ice Beam? I don't think so. So FLGL just clicks. FLGL just dies to the Ice Beam. I'm mixing up their names because they both start with F, FL, but Flame Victini, FLCL. My bad, guys. But yeah, I guess he was maybe max HP Taunt with Rocky Helmet, and there was potentially a roll the Ice Beam, depending on how much special attack investment the Greninja has. But yeah, you guys can see Effie had pretty good matchup in this one. Looking pretty over at this point. And now, I assume FLCL went for either Superpower or Hurricane that turn. And Effie, you see no life up on this Greninja, by the way. I assume it's Expert Belt Greninja. That's what Effie has used that in the past, I think last year in SPL. But yeah, now Greninja or Marvel have to come out here. And he can't even Oko this. Like, he can U-turn out for some chip, or maybe he has Loki on this, but I don't think that kills. So U-turns out. What did Effie go for? Does he have Pump on this? Or something to hit Tren? He does have a low kick, okay. So, pops the Heat Tren there. I assume we see the Morwell come out. Yep. Morwell does come out for FLCL. Threatens the Greninja with... well, Sucker Punch doesn't kill from here. And at this point, the game is pretty much over. I don't think Effie has a way to lose this. He can just go Heat Tren here to play it safe. Or he can even stay in to get some chip. He just go Heat Tren. Let's see if FLCL... he pulls a double into Greninja. I was gonna say, I thought he could have SD'd maybe and then Sucker Punch spam, I guess, hope for some crits. We are Greninja. We've seen U-turn. So either low kick or pump is most likely what this has to hit Heatran. So Effie goes to his own Greninja to see what FLCL locks himself into. He dodges a pump. And now if Effie wants, he can go Pharaoh here. But he can also stay in, like, it doesn't really matter too much. So FLCL doubles Morwell, I think predicting the Pharaoh Zone. Maybe he has Fire Fang on this or something like that. Well, even if he doesn't have Fire Fang on this, he kind of had to bank on him going Pharaoh there and try something like SD up. And now he already took chip on his Morwell. I think Effie can just stay in. And if FLCL doesn't Sucker Punch, he gets more chip on this. So he has extra sensory to hit stuff like Toxapex. And now, obviously, FLCL is forced to Sucker. I think Effie should just stay in, because if he switches on another SD, there could be a potential choke. So Landris comes out. I'm pretty sure Sucker doesn't kill. So FLCL just has to go for Sucker crit at this point. Doesn't get the crit, so Earthquake is going to pick up the Morwell. And now this Greninja cannot lock into a move. Well, it has to lock into Ice Beam and then get some freezes. That's the only way FLCL can win. So Ice Beam picks up the Lando. Now we see Heatran or Ferrothorn most likely come out. And Heatran is just going to click, I guess, Off Power or Magma. So he does click Off Power, and he just has to click Off Power again here and not get frozen. And he does get frozen. Okay, so that shouldn't matter, because he gets multiple chances to Saw, and even if he doesn't Saw, he can go into his Clef and have like two chances to hit a Moonblast. So FLCL has to freeze that as well. Or he can go into Ferrothorn. But Ferrothorn probably takes like 20 from Ice Beam, maybe 25. Depending on how much special attack this Gren runs, but I assume it doesn't do too much, like 20-ish. It's like somewhere mid-20s. So yeah, he's able to beat down the Heatran with the freeze, but he also has to freeze the Ferrothorn anti-Clef, and he's not able to do that, so Effie picks up the win here. But yeah, if you guys were hyped for Live Flame Victini games, you can stay tuned for the other two games. Effie already played all his three games. I recorded his game versus Sidoma's Live, and I recorded his game versus Zomok Live. So you can expect that sometime the next day. Stay tuned for that. Thank you guys for watching. And yeah, Effie had a better matchup, but he did also play it well. Stay tuned for more content. Smash that like button if you enjoyed. And I'll see you guys next time.